Welcome back, ESGN Nation, to another episode here on Madden 20. And this is the New York Giants franchise, episode number 17, as we're in the divisional round. And this week we are going to be taking on the New Orleans Saints. It's a snowy, cold afternoon here in the New York City area as the Giants are taking on the Saints in this divisional round game. Of course, the winner of this game will move on and head to the NFC Championship game. And both teams really want to get themselves back into the spotlight of the NFL, that being the Super Bowl. Of course, this is Drew Brees, possibly his last season. And of course, there you see Eli Manning. We're trying to get him to get a Super Bowl ring before he retires also. So two of these great quarterbacks here. Only one can move on to the next round. As you see, the Saints are 10-6 in the season there. Had a pretty good year. Not as good as they wanted, as the Panthers were the divisional round or the divisional leaders in that division there in the NFC South. They defeated the Bears in a really good game, 42-7 in the wild card round to move on to this game. And there you see the games from that round. As you see Drew Brees' numbers from that game, pretty good game, 283, three touchdowns, one interception, and of course, 23 of 31 in that game. Had a little bit of help there from the running game from Murray and also from Washington and Zach Line from the rushing department. They're both getting a touchdown and both getting over 30 yards in that game. So we'll definitely have to watch out for them. Of course, their receiving core, not the tip-top shape receiving core, but Cook, Glenn Jr., and Carr are definitely threats there to us coming up in this one as we take a look at the defensive numbers there. Of course, not the powerful defense that we know them to be in the years past, but they are definitely, with a game like they had against the Bears, anything is possible. Of course, we've had a week off and not be able to play some football here. Hopefully, we got some guys that we did have, actually have for some guys returning from injury. Not qualified to be in this game, but nonetheless, here we got a full strength roster and we are ready to go. So, we'll try to see if we can get Eli Manning a chance to get to a championship game in the NFC Championship game. Let's take a look at the Saints injury report going into this game here. And of course, they're just like us, they have quite a few guys. They're out. Of course, they got some guys coming back here and are eligible to come back in. And there you see Michael Thomas, the top wide receiver there for them, for their team. Of course, Breeze right behind them in overalls for their roster for the Saints. So this should be a good one. Saints are actually ranked 8th in passing yards in the league. And along with that, they are ranked 11th in rushing yards this season in the NFL. As for the defense, are 26th in the league with sacks. I should say 26th in the league with sacks, and also 5th in the league in interceptions. So we definitely have to watch out for our passing here. Not, get too pass happy in this game. It is, like I said, a cold, kind of a windy day also there on the field, and that means we're going to utilize the running game as much as we possibly can here. Now, to say that, even though they're not the best in, they are good in interceptions, but we may see some more opportunities to go for deep in the passing game, as they don't really have the best, the most top quality corners out there. But we are going to try to do our best here to get down the field and try to throw down the field as much as we can, as often as we can in this game. But most importantly, it is going to be a running situation here in this one, as Barkley has been just a monster on the field and pretty much has the took the MVP this season for the Giants. As you take a look at our play or our playbook looks, or I should say our offensive play game plan is for this. And of course, short passes, and of course, watch out for the passing game here. Hopefully our corners and deep safety, stuff like that, are ready to go at a moment's notice. Now, the winner of this game, of course, to either take on the Detroit Lions or the Panthers, and we'll see, hopefully we'll see something in the bottom of the ticker there of who we get to play who the next team, I should say. We shouldn't say us because it may not necessarily be us in this one. So we'll say here it's going to be a tough game. We'll see how things go. See a kickoff there. It is a touchback, and they'll be on their own 25-yard line as we take a look here at Drew Brees. And there you see the numbers he's put up this season so far. 31 touchdowns, 18 interceptions, over 4,000 yards. And, of course, he is trying to go out on top here as try to get to the Super Bowl one more time before he decides to hang him up. So now first and 10, ball on their own 25-yard line. And we'll see Brees throws this one up there. And that's going to be an interception. Haley's going to get this one for the Giants. And then he's going to try to take this one back. And he's going to take that one back to the 15-yard line. Great job. Way to start off in the defense there for us as he gets the first, first play of the game and the first interception in this one. So we'll see. It might seem like a good day here for the defense as they're able to pick that one up and now, of course, help us out of trying to put in the first points on the board here for the Giants. So there you see Eli at the 15-yard line here. Drops back here. Throws this one up there. That's going to go up, but nobody can get to as Ingram just gets away from him there on that one. Second and 10, ball on the 15. And we'll see here another chance here for a deep pass there, but Manning will get taken down there by Cam Jordan, who's just a monster. And definitely one of those guys we're going to have to watch out for in this game. If he gets too fired up and gets too many chances at the quarterback there, it's going to be a long day there for Eli. So we throw this one up there. That's going to be an incomplete pass intended for Ingram as he could not come down with it. So it's going to be a 4th and 20. And that means we're going to have to try to go for a pretty deep field goal here. 42 yards here. The wind is blowing off to the right-hand side here. And we'll see the kick is up. And the kick is not going to be any good as it hits off the pole on the far left side there. And Rosa, not a good day there starting off. Thought we had something there. But unfortunately, with the wind blowing the way it is, just not enough there. I think just a little too much oomph there in that kick. And that is not going to put no points on the board there for us. So Drew Brees could come back out here. I see there he threw that first pass in this game for his first interception. So back on their own 32-yard line, first and 10 for the Saints as they are trying to see if they can get themselves on the board here themselves as they get that one to, looks like, I believe, one of the wide receivers, Cook, in that little screen pass there. Could not get it to him. Now we go to see an RPO, and that's going to be a nasty hit. Second and 12. We'll see Golden pick up the ball, and the Giants get the ball back here. That is now two turnovers and two straight drives here now in this ball game. So can the Giants put something on the board this time around? Manning throws up the middle there to Ingram, and Ingram gets the catch, and that is going to put us at first and 10. Ball on the Saints 7-yard line. So now first 10 again for the Giants. And oh, that was a scary tip pass there. Could have easily been picked off, but no one could get a hold of it. So go to a second and 10. Ball on the 7-yard line here. Hand this one off to Barkley. Barkley's going to try to get around the corner, around the edge. He can't keep his balance. And he's going to roll there, and he's going to about lose a yard there on that play. So now ball on the 8-yard line, third and goal. Manning here looking down the field here, looking up, trying to see who he can get to. And can he get in the end zone? Touchdown, Giants. And that is a great touchdown there to Golden Tate as he picks up a first touchdown of the day here in this NFC divisional round game. Nice job as he gets the catch. And he is putting us on the board here. And that's hopefully a start of a good thing here for the Giants. As the Giants defense now, twice now, put us in great field position now. But only once we're able to score on that turnover. So going now to a first and 10, ball on the 25-yard line here of the Saints. As the Saints really having a tough time trying to get out of their side of the 50. So go to now to a second and 3. Ball on the 26-yard line. And we'll see a pass there up the middle. That is going to go. Oh, He almost got away with that one, as I believe that's Cook there. Almost got away with it. Now we'll see another RPO and then another great pass. This time we cannot get a hold of it. I was going to say that's going to be three in a row, but Thomas is able to get the ball there on time, and that puts him now back at the 25-yard line, making a second and 21. I don't know what's going on with Breeze on the passing or the guys. I don't know if it's Breeze just bad accuracy or if it's just the pressure or just Thomas not being able to hold on to the football here today. I mean, it is a cold day. He is wearing gloves. We'll go to the now second and 21. We'll see a pass there, and that's just going to give them a couple of yards there from the tight end. So ball in the 27-yard line. Breeze drops back here in the pocket. Breeze gets taken down, and that is B.J. Hill on that play, as Hill is able to get a stop there, and then we get a quick we get him out for the field there, and they get punt the ball. So we get the ball on our own 33-yard line, first and 10, first time we've been back this far on the field, as we'll see Barkley here tries to run this one there, and Cam Jordan reads that run very well on that quick stop. Go now to a ball in the 34-yard line. Manning looking to go deep here, and that's going to be intercepted by Davis, as Davis is able to pick that one off, as the defense did a great job there just scrambling the coverage there. So now Giants now back on defense, as the Saints now back on the field here. Hand that one off to Murray. Murray's going to try to run this one. Does a good job there juking, or I should say Washington there on that play. And he is able to get the or just shy of the first, as we'll see a great pass from Breeze on that play. I just realized Murray is out of the game, so that was I had to correct myself there. I realized like that is wrong. So we'll see now the twin set there in the backfield as we go to a third and two, and hand this one off to Washington there. Washington trying to get out of the backfield, and he does so. As it gets to the 17-yard line, it's another first and 10 for the Saints. Saints looking to try to get back into this game here. As we're four minutes and 3 seconds left here in the first quarter. And that's going to be a stop there as Breeze gets a – or his wide receiver gets a reception there for the first. Or just shy, or excuse me, just way shy of the first. We'll see a pass there. That's going to go to Cook, and Cook gets this one as he is taken there at the 3. I think actually mark him at the 2. It's first and goal, and oh, Breeze cannot just get back and set at all as Martin's right in there on the sack, and that puts him at the 7-yard line. Nice loss there from the defense onto the Saints. Third and goal. We'll see a pass play. That one gets tipped around, but no one can hold on to it, as that's going to be a complete pass. And that's going to force now the Saints to now kick a field goal. Try to put some points on the board here, and that's exactly what they do, as they put the first 3 points on the board there for themselves. So it's now a 7-3 ball game. Ball on the 24-yard line here for the Giants. It's Manning back on the field. Manning throws a quick short pass there to his tight end, and that'll be just a couple yards shy there of the marker. Second and 4, ball on the 30-yard line. Manning dropping back again, looking down the field. Throws this one up there. That's going to be caught, and that's going to go to Ingram for the first. Near midfield now, first and 10. Trying to see if we can get on the board here once again. This time we're going to the ground game, and Barkley gets a nice run, but it stopped abruptly. So ball on the 44-yard line, second and 8. And we'll see another handoff to Barkley, and Barkley shoots out there like a rocket out of the backfield and gets enough there for the first, as he again is able to move the chains. That's what he's been doing all season long, very well here and for this team. First and 10. 9 seconds left before we get in the first quarter. Barkley tried to get out of the backfield, and he'll be barely gets past the line of scrimmage there to get a couple of yards. Go now to a second and 7. Hand off to Barkley again. He finds a first down marker, grabs a little bit more, and he is taken down at the 30 for another first down. That's what they need to do there. Run the ball up the middle. Make them work. Make them have to collapse in the middle there. Put eight men in the box. And that's so far, that's not what the Saints are doing right now. Saints just don't know how to stop Barkley. So we'll see now, first and 10 here, ball on the 30-yard line. And again, Barkley finds another nice hole there to the left-hand side and runs this one as he's getting approaching the four, just near 40 yards here in today's game. Seven carries at this point. Under 10 minutes left here in the second quarter. See ball on the 20-yard line. Manning throws up the middle there. And oh, intended there for Tate? Or no, I think it was Terrell. There for the pass, as that was incomplete. Second and 10. Manny's going to drop back in the pocket. Good pocket, but no. Cam Jordan comes out of nowhere and brings him down for a sack. That's the second sack in the game here from Cam Jordan onto Eli Manning. So now it's third and 17. He's going to have to make sure he gets this ball out of there. And that is going to be a nice catch, but it's just going to be shy of the first down marker as Ingram does get the catch. It is second and 4. So instead of kicking the ball for a field goal, they're going to go for it here on fourth and 2. As they're on their 12-yard line of the Saints, as we'll see Barkley try to get the backfield there, but no, the defense reads that one. Cam Jordan and company gets there, and they get the stop. That's turnover on downs. They'll be at their own 12-yard line. So first and 10, not a good call there from the Giants that time around. They should have got points. See, Breeze there throws this one up there to the receiver. And that is going to be a first down there for Drew Breeze and the Saints. So go now to the ball on the 26-yard line. We'll see a pass there. That's going to be a quick pass there, and that's enough for the first. I believe that was Cook there. I can't remember who that was. But nonetheless, see another quick pass, this time to Washington underneath the coverage. And he gets this one, and he'll get a gain of 6 there on the play. Second and 4, ball on the 42-yard line. Breeze dropping back here, looks up, throws it there, finds an open man there to Cook, and he gets this one wide open on that play. And that's a first down for the Giants, or excuse me, for the Saints. Breeze again now back in the pocket here. Breeze cannot find nobody. Everybody's pretty much covered. And Golden gets in there for the sack. First sack of the day for him. Puts him now back at the 43. Makes it now a second and 19 for the Saints. It's just Drew Breeze could not find nobody there. He had to do something with that ball. But instead holds on to it too long. And that's going to cost him now. So they're going to have to look for a big play here coming up. And this next down. As we go now to a third and 6. Ball on the 30-yard line. Breeze drops back. Finds an open man. And oh, a nice hit there on Cook. And then we see Bertha's going to take this back here. Can he go back for a pick 6? He does so. Touchdown, Giants. And the Giants take the lead here. As we're just 6 minutes left here in the half, and that's a big play there. What a hit there from, I don't know who exactly gave the hit, but nonetheless, just a brutal hit, and just a great way to switch the momentum in this one here, as Brother gets this one, and he takes this one to the end zone for a nice, it's Baker. Nice job. Baker's been very quiet here in this playoffs here. Pretty much, he's been quiet for the first or second half of the season. He was everywhere there in the first half. But since then, we have not heard too much of him. But he makes a big, impactful play there as he gets the forced fumble there. And that is going to be nice. And that's going to put now us up here by a possession. So take a look at some of the issues that Drew Brees is having in this one here. And it's been a tough day for him. I don't know if it's the weather or if it's just the receivers or just this defense. But nonetheless, it's not been a good day. And I don't think it's a good showing here. Not what he wants to have on his possible last game of his career. As we'll see, Haley there gets the tackle. But, he does stop and avoid getting the first down. Now, third and inches. We'll see Washington gets the ball handoff to him. And he does get enough there to go ahead and move the chains there for the Saints with 5:15 left here in the second or in the first half. Ball on the 36-yard line there, pass there quickly, and that's another first down there for Drew Brees and company. On that one, is able to move the chains. Go down midfield, Drew Brees, good pocket here, looking down the field, finds a man open, gets this one in there. That is going to be a catch, and that is going to be a first down, well sure, for Ginn Jr. on that one. Go now, play action here. Drew Brees fires this one up. That was going to be caught, and that's going to be in bounds there, they say. Just shy of the marker. Third and one now. Ball on the 14-yard line here. Play action here for Drew Brees. Drew Brees, though, he holds on way too long. It's Ogletree reads that one very well. Pushes them back to the 22. And it's going to be a fourth and nine situation here now for him. As we'll see the hit there. Nice hit. And like I said, they've been putting some nice hits on Brees here. Don't want to hurt the old man there, but nonetheless, they've been doing a great job here of just mixing up the coverage here and putting on the pressure from Brees. And that's what we've been looking for all season long to every single quarterback we've been trying to get a hold of. So we'll see the kick here. The kick is up and the kick is in as they get their another 3 points there on the board, making it now a 14-6 ball game as they just come up shy there. Had a great drive there that time around, but now they really need to start putting some points. They need to get some touchdowns here at some point, as we'll see a nice spin move there from Barkley, and Barkley will be at the 32-yard line of that run, just shy of the first down. And see again, Barkley here runs this one there, gets out of backfield, and they're just utilizing the clock very well. So at the 2 minute warning here, just taking their time here. Don't necessarily need to score, but I would think they would like to score, at least put some points up on the board before the half ends. As we go now to a 3rd and 7 here, Manning has two in the backfield there with him. And we'll see what Manning and the Giants are going to do here as Manning drops back here, throws this one up there to Leitner. And Cody Leitner, I should say, gets the catch, and then it's going to be a first down for him. 50 seconds left here, 1st and 10, ball on the 49-yard line of the Saints. And we'll see a handoff there to Barkley. Barkley trying to get out of the backfield there, but it gets wrapped up very quickly, only getting a gain of 2 on the play, if that. 2nd and 8, we'll see Barkley here trying to get out of the backfield there. Gets around the edge, breaks a tackle, but is at the 35. And they'll have to call a quick timeout. They have one timeout remaining for the Giants. As we go to a 3rd and 6. Manning trying to get some momentum going here. He throws this one up there. That's going to be tipped away. Good job there from the defender. Unfortunately, Tate couldn't hold on to it. Really couldn't get to it. Or actually, I think he batted it away. So the defender couldn't get to it. So now it's a 4th and 5. They're going to go for here with 14 seconds left. I think they can probably get 3 points if worst case scenario. Get themselves in field goal range here. And they're going to go for it here. Manning throws this one up. And that's going to be an incomplete pass. That's the second time now they've gone for on 4th down. That's another turnover on downs. As see Drew Brees and the Saints get back on the field quickly, throwing a pass there. Incomplete. Set 3rd and 2. Or excuse me, 2nd and 3. That ball is going to be thrown up there. That is going to be tipped around, and it's going to be intercepted there. Nice play as they get this one at the 2-yard line. That is how the first half is going to end. I was really expecting with the way the Saints were playing last week against the Bears, this would be a bit of a shootout, but so far it's been a pretty it's defensively, I guess you could say, not too high-scoring game. But I would think they'd be a lot closer to us or us to them. And just take a look there. That game coming up between Detroit and Carolina coming up a little later on. And we'll have to find out and see if we can win this game for ourselves. And see if we do win this game, we'll see who we'll play in the NFC Championship game. But right now, we got a second half to get to. 14-6. Let's see the kickoff start off here, the third quarter. And we'll see Hamilton here has this ball. And Hamilton gets down to the 27-yard line from the kick return there. As you see his numbers there for this game so far. Barkley 14 carries, 62 yards in this one. Hasn't gotten to the end zone just yet, but I'm sure they're going to get him in there at some point. See a man in motion, and we'll see a handoff there. Barkley trying to break a tackle. He does, but then gets wrapped up pretty quickly, getting a gain of 2. Go now to a second and 8. Man in motion there for the Giants. And it's going to be another handoff there to Barkley. Barkley's going to go on the outside there. Gets to the first down, sticks, and they go ahead and say he's short there at the 36. So now third and 1 here for the Giants. Giants look like they're playing a little bit more of the running game here. And, oh, Barkley just opened the doors up, going down the field. He is off to the races here. It's just now him, but they get him at the 11-yard line there in Saints territory. Wow, what a run there from Barkley as he takes off here. Let's take a look at this replay. Now, just that left-hand side just opens up. He just realizes he has nothing but green, or in this case, just white and green all in front of him, and he takes off. So nice run there from him. So I believe they'll probably finish this drive off with a pass. We'll see a quick pass there, and that is to the tight end Ingram on that one for the first, or just shy of the first there. Second and 6, I believe. Ball on the 7-yard line. Manning drops back in the pocket looking for an end zone pass, and he gets it there. Nice job as Cody Leitner gets in there, and that's a touchdown. First one for him for this postseason. And the Giants now take a 2-possession lead. It is now going to be 21-6 here in the third quarter. If the Saints do not turn around this game anytime soon here, this one is pretty much going to be over with there. You see the scoring drive. Nice drive there from him, especially coming off that big run there from Barkley. 18 of 24, 183. Two interceptions now for Drew Brees. Go to a first and 10 ball on the 25-yard line. That is going to be another pass. And that is going to be a first down there for the Saints. As we'll see, Drew Brees drop back here, fires, and oh my goodness, Haley almost had the interception, but it would have been his second there. So we'll see now a third and 10, ball on their own 39-yard line. Drew Brees trying to get away from B.J. Hill, and Hill's like, hell no, you're going down, as he gets the second sack in this one, and that's going to be a force of punt now. As we got the ball at our own 22, and you see Barkley just cannot get out of the backfield there. As the defender gets right there, sniffs the run out quickly. Go now to the ball on the 16-yard line there to Barkley. Barkley trying to break a tackle. They finally jump on him and take him down at the 24. Just a really tough day here for this defense. I was really expecting a lot more for this Saints defense as we go down to a 3rd and 8. Or I should say, 24-yard line here for the Giants. I see a pass there to Ingram. Ingram, the tight end, trying to do a little shake and move. But he does get the first. And that's going to put him there at their own 38-yard line. First and 10 for the Giants as Manning drives back here. He's got to get rid of this one as the blitz comes in there. That is Davis. Fifth tackle of the game. His first sack in this one makes it now a 2nd and 20. So they're on their own 28-yard line here. Manning looks, fires this one up there, throws that one to Cody Leitner. Leitner's already in the end zone already here today. He gets now to the 25 on that nice pass play, and that puts him in territory now here as they're on the Saints 25-yard line. First and 10 here for Manning. Manning looked like he's going for a short pass there to Ingram as he gets loses a yard on the play. 2nd and 11, ball on the 26-yard line. It is, snow is coming down here pretty hard now here in the second half. See, Manning gets taken down pretty hard, and that's a nice sack there I'm not even going to attempt to say that guy's name. Nonetheless, they're a nice one from the Saints defense. Third and 17. Manning drops back in the pocket, throws this one up there. That is going to be caught. Amazing enough, as that one is surprising enough from Cody Leitner, of all people, catches that. Oh, no. They say incomplete. I thought he had that one. Take a look here. It looks like, oh, he had, oh, no. He tipped out the last minute there from the defender. As, yeah, Alex there. Alonzo Lone tips it out. So now we go for 4th and 17 here. This is the third time Giants are going for it on 4th down. And Cam Jordan's like, you're not going to get it again, as he gets another sack here. His third sack in the game. That puts them now, the Saints, on their own 38-yard line after a turnover on downs. 21-6 here. I don't know why the Giants are going for it on 4th down. But they believe they can get a shot here on 4th down. But not when you have Cam Jordan there coming in off the edge there and gets the sack there, as they cannot really too much handle him. They've been trying to double team him and so many other ways of trying to slow him down, but that's a man that you just cannot take down too easily. First and 10, ball on the 38-yard line. Hand off there to Washington as he tries to get out of the backfield. He does so, and he does get enough there for the first. So now we'll see Drew Brees here on 1st and 10, ball on the 50. And the receiver cannot hold on to it. What is the deal there? As we'll see a handoff there as, oh, Washington gets stopped in the backfield quickly. There from Golden. Marcus Golden there on that stop. 3rd and 13. We'll see a pass up the middle, and that gets tipped away. And that is going to be an incomplete pass. And we'll see what the Saints will do. So Saints will go ahead and punt this ball now. 4th and 13. And the kick is up. And this one is going to be at the 8. So nice spot there to put us into. 1st and 10. Manning here drops back. Throws this one. And that one gets tipped away from the defense. So go now to a 3rd and 1. Ball on their own 17-yard line here. 2:30 left here in the third quarter. And we do get enough there from Barkley for the first. As the defense there is getting very frustrated now with this run from Barkley. Open backfield here, 4 wide. Or I should say 5 wide, actually, for the Giants. As Manning drops back here looking for a deep pass. He gets the air to Golden Tate. And Golden Tate gets another catch there. And that's a nice catch from him. His third reception of the game, surprisingly enough, here in today's game. Just can't really get to him there as that ball gets tipped away, intended for the backup tight end. 2nd and 10, ball on the 35-yard line. 1:29 left here in the third quarter. Pass there quickly there to Shepard, and Shepard gets the catch. And he'll get enough there for the first. So now 1st and 10 here, ball on the 48. We'll hand this one off to Barkley, and Barkley gets stopped as he barely gets a yard on that one. 2nd and 9, ball on the 46. We'll see a pass play up the middle, and that is going to be caught by Ingram, who gets the first. Nice play. 1st and 10 now, just 12 seconds left here before the end of the third quarter. 21-6 in this ball game. Ball on the 41-yard line. Cody Leitner again gets another great catch. He's been really very reliable for us here in today's game. As Eli's got now 203 yards, 2 touchdowns, and an interception. So Eli's been playing a really good game there, with the exception of that interception. For the most part there, he's been staying within his means. As we'll see here, Barkley gets handed this ball off to him. And he gets about 2 or 3 on the play. Go now to a 2nd and 6 as we start the fourth quarter here. Hand this off to Barkley. Barkley going up the middle, and Barkley gets enough for the first. So Barkley looking very good here, very sharp here in this one. And we'll need him a lot more here in this quarter to see Manny try to get rid of the football there. But, of course, Cam Jordan there again. Fourth sack of the day, 5 tackles, as he is really making a name for himself in this one. Second and 16. We'll see a pass there to Ingram. Ingram drops the football. Not what we need. And the defense picks it up and takes it back to the 29-yard line. Nice fumble recovery there from Davis. And yeah, Ingram, you need to shake your head because that right there should have been a catch. You know better there. You got to hold on to that football. But they strip it right out from him and now have possession of the football. And now trying to put something together here in this drive. Let's take a look at the replay there. And they just did a great job there ripping the ball right out of our tight end's hands. And we'll have to see what we can do now here on defense as it's still a two-possession game. First and 10 here for Breeze as he throws this one there to Washington out of the backfield there. And Washington stopped at the 37. Gets a gain of 8 on the play. Second and 8. See, Breeze throws this one up there. That gets tipped around, but it's going to be picked up by Peppers. And Peppers gets a hold of it at the 47-yard line. The Giants are back in possession now. I'm sure Breeze is probably thinking, man, I want this game over with here. This is not my day. So now first and 10, ball on the 47. Manny dropping back here, looks up, throws that one away as there's nobody there. Has to get rid of it because of the pressure. He's already been sacked now, what, 4 or 5 times now in this game. 4 of those being coming from Cam Jordan himself. As Cam Jordan, again, puts the pressure on him, throws it away again. And it's going to be a 4th and 10 now for the Giants as they'll be faced again now to make a decision if they're going to go ahead and punt. And that's what they're going to do here. Of course, we could see a fake punt here in this situation. We'll see the punt. No, it's actually a legitimate punt. This punt is going to go and it's going to be a coffin punt as it's going to be at the Saints' 1-yard line. Oh, my goodness. Look at that. That's a beautiful punt. Great job there from our punter. So we'll see if we can try to get a safety here as Drew Brees drops back in the pocket. Has to throw this one up. Wide open there from Washington. And Washington going all the way down to the 43-yard line. Nice job there. Getting himself open. And we just blew that coverage there on that play. Trying to go for that sack in the end. Or trying to go for that safety there. First and 10. Breeze there, drop. Oh my goodness, couldn't have been a catch there, but the receiver could not hold on to it as the Breeze just cannot get on target here. This one, as we'll see, Cook there gets the catch, again, Junior gets the catch. He's getting the gets another reception. There's third one. I believe Cook was the second guy to touch that ball. There on that tip there, he couldn't hold on to it. Breeze now drops back, first and 10. Hill, B.J. Hill again, gets another sack, his third in the game. 3 tackles, 3 sacks in this one here. Puts him now back at the 44, making a second and 19 for Drew Breeze and the Saints on offense. So now third and 10 here, ball on the 47-yard line. That one gets tipped away. And now the Saints have a decision to make if they're going to go for it or will they punt it. Well, they're going to decide to go for it here. Fourth and 10, Drew Brees drops back in the pocket. Great pocket there for him. Throws this one up there. That one gets caught. How in the hell did Thomas get a hold of that? He does so there. And that's a first down. Wow. First play or first and 10 now here. Ball in the 23-yard line. Breeze gets hit. That's a fumble. The big man there for the offensive line recovers it. And Overtree takes him down for the sack or for the tackle there. It will be considered a sack. And that will be a third and 16. As we go now to the next play here, we'll see a pass there from the tight to the tight end there from Breeze. And that's going to be put him at the 23-yard line. Fourth and 10. And another fourth down situation. Saints trying to get this game a little closer now here, even though we're just 5 minutes left here. Throw a ball up there for a jump ball, and no one can get to it as we put the nice pressure there on Drew Brees. First and 10 here, handing this one off to Barkley. Barkley coming out of the back of the field there, and he is going to run this one to the 42-yard line. He has now over 160 yards here in today's game, 24 carries. here in this one, as we'll see see Barkley again runs this one for a couple more yards. Third and four. Manning, two receivers, two backs in the backfield there. Split set. Manning throws this one up there to Cody. Cody Leitner here. Cole gets this one, and he does a little juke, but gets taken down at the 31. Holds on to the football there. That's another first and 10. So we go now to a first and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. Manning throws this one up there to Ingram. Ingram holds on to it. Not stripped away from him like last time. And that's a 22-yard reception. Another first down. First and goal now. Ball on the 9-yard line here. Trying to put an exclamation point on this drive here and this game. As you see Eli here making some changes here. Making multiple changes now. Hand this one off here to Barkley. Barkley gets into the end zone for the first time today. And that's a first touchdown of the day for him. And another touchdown there for the Giants. And they make it now a three-possession lead. Making it now 28-6. This game is pretty much over with here. Not much what the Saints can do in this one here. As they make just a bad showing here in this divisional round game. Drew Brees talking to his guys, letting them know, hey, we got to do something here. We got to get better here in this next drive. So let's see what they can do here. First and 10. And just under 3 minutes left here in this one. Drew Brees throws this one there. And that's going to be reception for Cook. His ninth of the day there, making a first down. So now we go to another first and 10. Brees drops back here, throws this one up there. That's going to be a reception. And that is going to be another catch there, I believe, for Cook again. Second and one up the middle there. That's going to be caught, and that is going to be a first down. As Smith gets the reception there for the first. And we'll see a quick, actually, no, two-minute warning now here for the Saints. Not much for the Saints to get back in this one here. They're going to try to do their best. Go now to a first and 10. Pass there, short there to their fullback. And the fullback gets stopped as he gets hit hard. Holds on to the football. And they're going to do no huddle. So now, minute 37 left here for Drew Brees. Drew Brees going to throw this one over to his right-hand side. And gets that one to Cook there for just shy of the first down marker. As Brees again, no huddle. And Lawrence this time gets a hold of him for another sack. Tough day here for Drew Brees as they go no huddle here. Fourth and 13. Just near a minute left in this one here. A pass there at Washington. Washington can't get to the first down. Sticks. And that is going to be our turnover on downs. As Ogletree and this defense has just been on fire. Showing what they can do. And there you see Sean Payton not liking what his team has done here today. And we see the final score 28-6 in this one. 214 yards passing for the Giants. 200 yards rushing for the Giants. Nice balanced game here for them. And, of course, Eli Manning will now move on to the next round. And, of course, Drew Brees. Well, the question is he going to let this be the last game of his career? Or will we see him back next season? We'll have to find out and see as you see the numbers there. 345, I should say, for Drew Brees. As for us, 258, 18-32, two touchdowns, and one interception. Barkley, 33 for 200, and a touchdown for him on the ground. Washington, 7 of 29 for the Saints. Drew Brees, two carries for negative 3 yards in the game. Highly unusual. And then we'll see Ingram, 9 for 106. As for Cody Lattimore, 5 for 105 for a touchdown. Golden Tate, 3 for 32 and a touchdown there in the game. And kind of a quiet day for him. We tried our best to get to him, but they were just covering him way too well. And but it was nice to see someone else to be able to step up in the game and make a challenge to this defense. Like I said, they put a number. I mean, this defense did a number on the Bears. And I don't know where that defense went off to this week. Cam Jordan's the only one who really pretty much showed up in this game. He had 4 sacks in the game, 6 tackles, 5 of them were solo. and he had one tackle for loss. As for us on defense, Ogletree, 9 tackles, 2 tackles for loss, a sack. Jenkins, 9 tackles, a tackle for loss. Peppers, 9 tackles, tackle for loss. BJ Hill, 5 tackles, 3 sacks. Marcus Golden, 3 tackles, tackle for loss, and a sack. Tomlinson, a tackle and a sack also. And Baker, he had that tackle, or at 5 tackles, forced fumble, and 2, or actually 2 forced fumbles and a sack. And of course, Betha, he had that, he had a touchdown, football, a fumble recovery, and he had 5 tackles in the game. That was very nice. As we see, Coach gets a chance to upgrade on some things here for himself. And we're going to work on DBs. We're going to boost our DB training there. So we're going to work on that. That's what we're going to do with our XP here. But first, we're going to look at some others here that we could possibly go after. But yeah, we're going to work on DBs, getting them stronger, getting them better. Especially with the way they played here, it was really nice to see them to be able to put the hurt on a lot of guys here against the Saints. As take on, see here, we've got some player upgrades. Barkley, of course, had a nice upgrade there. He had a nice game. Julian Peppers there, also getting an upgrade there for himself. 87 overall now, as he gets the hybrid upgrade. Tomlinson, there you see, he gets a nice upgrade, as he's going to be a speed rusher upgrade to 72. And got BJ Hill, of course, like I said, he had a nice game, had a sack. Actually 3 sacks and 5 tackles in that one. Really definitely did a great job showing up. And of course Haley, he had that interception at the beginning of the game, working on his man-to-man. Bill had also an upgrade there. So we got several guys get some upgrades in this one, which was very nice to see, because the next round is going to be even tougher now. Like I said, we either have this Lions or we have the Panthers coming up, and either way it goes, it's going to be a tough game for us, because those two teams are, you know, especially the way that the Lions, who we're actually going to be playing here, surprisingly enough, have been putting some good numbers up this season, especially this postseason. So a great another challenge here. Hopefully it won't be like the game like we had with the Saints. Hopefully it'll be a lot closer and also more exciting. But nonetheless, yeah, I'm very happy to get that victory. And we'll try to see what we can do coming up in the next episode. So stay tuned for the next episode, you guys, as we trying to see who we're, or of course we already know who we're gonna play, but we'll see how this is gonna play out here as we get ready for the NFC Championship game at home against those Lions. Lions had a nice season there for themselves, and we'll see if we can try to punch our ticket and get to the Super Bowl and try to get another Super Bowl ring for Eli Manning before he decides to walk off in the sunset and retire. So that's all coming up here next in episode 18 as we go to the NFC Championship game against the Lions. If you guys enjoyed today's episode, please leave a like on the video. Not to mention, if you're happy to be new, hit that subscribe button and hit that bell notification so you guys can be notified of this series or any other series here on the channel. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Discord. Links are down below in the description. If you want to help support the channel in a financial way, by helping us with better equipment and programs, stuff like that, editing equipment, stuff like that, we do have a Patreon page. The link's also down below, or maybe up in the eye up there. Definitely that's a great way you guys can be a part of the series. You guys want a character or a player or something in our Highland Scotty series there, or any other series we have coming up here soon here on the channel. Also, don't forget to follow us on our other channel, ESGNet LP. It's our secondary channel. Has some other great stuff on there too. So definitely check us out there. Follow us there on that one. But that's it for this episode of the New York Giants franchise. Stay tuned for episode 18 coming up very, very soon. As always, keep yourselves together healthy, wear a mask, and I will see you guys next time.